I'd like to first congratulate Fairfield on winning the championship. They played well all season long, and today was, you know, no different. I know we had them on the ropes, played really tough. We fought, but just obviously came up, you know, just a hair short. But I couldn't be more proud of our group for the efforts, the energy, the love, you know, for one another, and the will to want to fight. To take that team into overtime was huge, and you know, that's something to be proud of. This year has been amazing. I know we're not done yet. You know, we do have postseason to play, but the journey has been fun with this group. They've worked extremely hard since June, and you know, I know that they're going to continue to fight, you know, and whoever we get to play in postseason. But, you know, unbelievable experience so far, and breaking records, setting records, doing all the things. And I just can't thank, you know, our seniors, you know, for all that they've done to kind of lead the way with our younger players.
Thank you, Coach. We'll start with Rachel.
This question's for both Angel and Amelia. Overtime, what was your team's strategy going into overtime?
Just to stay disciplined, stick to our principles, do what we did, do what we were doing.
Yeah, the same thing.
Well, Amelia, though, how did Fairfield take control in overtime?
I would say they just attacked our weak points. And that's what they harped on. And was consistent, because we knew what they were going to do. We knew they were going to shoot threes, and that's what they came to do in the fourth. I mean, in the overtime, and that's what they did.
Other questions for the student athletes?
I'll continue. The shooting, what did Fairfield also do to cut down on your team shooting in the fourth quarter?
I'll say they pressured our point guards, and really they knew that if they shut down the point guards, that our shooters wouldn't get it, and definitely taking away the shooters. Even though we had inside presence, I feel like that was their strategy, maybe, because that's what they were doing.
Angel, what did it mean for you and for your program to get to this point, play for an NCAA tournament and for a championship?
It meant a lot. Obviously, our program hasn't been here in a while, and just to get that opportunity is amazing.
And you're out of eligibility now, but what kind of place do you want to leave this program in? What do you want to do? What do you want to see moving forward from what you've done here?
I just want us to build on what we've already done. I think we've in the 5 years, we've built a program for wanting to win. And I have no doubt that we will get there.
Amelia, what's it going to take for this program to keep doing that?
Buying in, doing our principles. We just got to go back to the drawing board and do more. Do what we do, add on more than what we did here.
All good. Amelia, Angel, thank you very much for taking the time. And Angel, congratulations on your career.
Thank you.
Whenever you're ready, Rachel.
Jada, what was different about this game, your team in this game against Fairfield, as opposed to the other two games you played against Fairfield?
I think our mindset was a lot better going into this game. I think we were prepared to kind of do the game plan, whereas I felt the last two games that we played them, we weren't really executing the game plan. So I think they were locked in, you know, from the beginning and wanting to stick with what we were asking them to do. And that was the result of us being up, you know, at halftime. And, you know, obviously Fairfield came out. They made their adjustments in the second half. And we, you know, battled and competed. But I do feel like the mindset was definitely better coming into this game. And, you know, we always talk about, you know, the mind being a powerful organ. And it was definitely that today. We came out ready to go.
What was it, Jada? Keep asking questions. And what was it? What were the adjustments that Fairfield made in the second half to get back?
I think they wanted to be a little more deliberate about getting downhill. You know, we did get in some foul trouble as far as them driving and kicking and really looking to get shooters. I think they made more of an emphasis on doing that in the second half than they did in the first half. So I think that kind of put us on our heels a bit. You know, rotations weren't where they needed to be, and we weren't able to keep Brown in front of us sometimes. And then obviously putting them at the line didn't help because then they were getting free points, you know, that way. So we needed to be a little more disciplined with not fouling.
Your team lost Aaliyah and Marley to foul trouble to the five fouls. How did that impact your team?
I think it impacted us a lot because you're talking about two players that are, you know, defensive stoppers, if you will. They do a great job on that end of the floor. They're vocal. They can guard multiple positions. They rebound the ball, especially Aaliyah. So I think that, you know, that really hurt us a bit, and you're always looking for somebody else or two other people to step up. And we just needed a little bit more with other people stepping up.
And taking Brown out early on, how much did that impact the game, and how did that – how'd your team capitalize on that?
I think we did a really good job of capitalizing on that. I think, you know, she starts a lot for them defensively, and I think it was a lot easier for us to really get into stuff, get out and run, get into things on offense when she was out of the game. Mm-hmm. And I think we did capitalize on that a lot.
Mm-hmm. And then also with this team, with this program, Angel Parker is going to be leaving at a group that's going to be, you know, exiting soon. But what place is this program in? What's the next step this program has to take to get back to this final day?
Angel's leaving his program, you know, better than what she got it, better than when she came in, and we're very thankful for that. I think now as we move onward and upward with the program, we want to continue the momentum of what it takes to get here, and we know what it takes to get here. Whereas maybe we didn't know in the past. We were feeling our way like last year and having a tough loss in the semis. But I feel like we now know what it takes to get here, and I think that's going to be the motivation that we'll need as we go into the off season.
What does it take to get here?
It takes a little bit more, a little bit more discipline, a little bit more of buy-in. Like Millie said, I think we were getting a good, decent amount of buy-in for the most part, but we also had sometimes there were some struggles. And I think you want to have everybody on the same page all the time in order to make that leap and that jump. And for us, it's not the huge jump that you have to make, but it's the hardest jump to make from going from 2-1.
Coach Pierce, a lot to be proud of this year, and we look forward to what you do in the postseason.
All right, thank you.